guys, welcome back to my channel the SJ kitchen. So in today's video we'll be making a puff dough, a patties dough or a croissant dough in India, if anybody doesn't understand what is a puff dough. So puff dough are also different types, there are different types of making a puff dough and also there are different type of puff dough. So we are making a laminated puff dough today. A laminated puff dough is similar to your like croissant dough and or your Danish dough, and you can create multiple desserts out of it. So let's start. And also I'll put it in the description box below for a detailed recipe of this, so you can go to that site, go to my blog and see the detailed recipe. So here we are starting with the puff dough. So here it is, the ingredients. So we are taking flour first. Flour. And here I'm going to mix my yeast mixture, which I've already made. I've added my active dry yeast in the warm water. And I will add it into the flour. You can make a bay like this, a center in it, so that. And you can add it like this into it. Okay, and now I'm going to put some powdered sugar. If you have normal sugar, you can also put normal sugar in it. Sugar in it. Okay, and salt. Okay, now I'm going to knead this dough and make it into a dough and tell you how we'll do it. Okay, so I'll be also adding milk into it to form a nice dough. You can see I'm making a dough right now. I'm adding milk into it. And if you feel your dough is still sticky, you can add a little bit more water into it. So I'm going to make a dough and then I'll show you how the dough turns out. Okay, so my puff dough is ready and I'll show you how it has turned out. Okay, so this is my puff dough. And if you can see, I'm putting it and it will come back to its shape. So I'm giving it a rest for around 20 to 30 minutes. And then it will double in size because of the yeast in it. And then we will start rolling it and we'll laminate it and turn it into a puff dough. And I'll show you how. So let it rest for 30 minutes and then I'll show you how to laminate the dough. Okay guys, so after 30 minutes my puff dough or lag is ready. I'm just going to show you. Okay, now you guys can see it. And see, can you see it? It's soft. So this dough is tend to be soft. So what I'm going to do is I've dusted some flour down and on top, and I'm going to roll it out. And I'm going to add, first I'm going to make it a little bit size wise. And I'm going to roll it down. Okay, so I've rolled this down this much, and now I'm going to I've taken 150 grams of butter, soft butter. So what you're going to do is divide your butter into three parts and or two parts and mix it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix it, laminate my half dough. One side I'll not mix, one, two. So this side and this side. So I'm going to mix it like this so that it gets incorporated. Just laminate it like this. Divide your dough into three, one, two, and three. Laminate the two part nicely and don't laminate the one part. like this. You can use a puff margarine. A puff margarine comes. So there's a different butter for puffs. So you can use that. Use soft butter so that you know it's easy. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to give it a fold like this. One and two like this, and one and two like this. And now I'm going to set this in the fridge for 10 to 15 minutes, and then we'll give it a fold like this again, around 3 or 4 folds, a book fold, which I'm going to show you, and then a puff dough will rest. So I'm going to put this in the fridge for resting. So I've transferred my dough into a cellophane sheet, and I'm going to, you know, just fold it over here and like that, and keep it for resting in the fridge for around 10 to 15 minutes. Then again take out. Okay, so after 10 minutes I've taken out my dough after resting, and again I'm going to, you know, dust my rolling bin, and I'm going to knead it. You can see the pockets coming out like this. If when you're rolling your dough, if the pockets are coming out, don't worry, because that's a good sign. So it means your dough is getting incorporated and it will get layers. So this is how, you know, in puff dough we get layers. So I'm going to shape it again like this. Okay, now again I've divided my dough into three parts, if I can show you like this. 1, 2, 3. I'll put my butter on two parts, and one part will be empty. So I'm again going to do that same. I'm going to rub my margarine all over the dough. Okay, again it's done, and now I'm going to give it a fold. So this over here and this on top. This like this, like a book. I'm going to fold it like this. So this is my fold, and now I'm going to again wrap it in a cellophane sheet and again keep it for rest for around 10 to 15 minutes, and then again do this type of procedure. So we have to do this procedure 3 times, and 4th time we'll give a blindfold, and then we'll keep it for resting for around 2-3 hours, and then we can use it. It's better to use your puff dough, make your puff dough overnight beforehand, so that you can use the dough next, because it will get a resting time also, and your puff pastry will get a nice moist flavor, and the layers will also come. So let's do. Okay, so again I've taken out for the third fold my dough, and I'm again going to roll it out into a nice big rectangle shape. You can see it is easily getting rolled just because, you know, of the butter, and the dough is like that. So this dough is very easy for croissants and for any puff Danish pastry. So this is the third time I'm putting it. So again, I'll divide the dough 1, 2, and I'm going to coat two sides of it. And again, I will rest it for 20-15 minutes, and then I will give a blindfold to it. So this is the last time I'm using the butter. Okay, so I've done that. Now I'm again going to give it a fold. I'm adding a little bit maida so that, you know, it gets and again I'm going to cover it with the cellophane paper into the fridge and rest it for 10 minutes. Okay, so I've taken out my dough again, and this is the last fold I'm going to give, and it will be a blind fold, no butter. And again, so I'm going to roll it out again. So we've already given 3 folds. Now this is the last fold, and then I'll keep it for resting. And after 2 or 3 hours, the dough is ready to use. So this is ready. I'm just going to dust it a little bit with flour, and now I'm going to give it a fold. So 1, 2, again roll it. Three, four, like a book, and 5. So this is a book fold, and now I'm going to give it a rest and use the dough after 2-3 hours. Okay guys, so that was the recipe for the puff dough. I have kept it for resting, and I'll be using it tomorrow, next day, so for my puff pastry. So see you tomorrow with the next new video of mine for a puff pastry dough. And that was the puff pastry, how to make a puff pastry dough at home. You can also try it and let me know how your puff pastries have come out. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends, and it will help me to grow as in the channel also, and in the future also with this channel. And this will encourage me. So please do like my video if you really like it. And for a detailed recipe, I'll put the link below in the description box. You can check it over there on my blog or on my Facebook. I also put a link of my Facebook profile and Insta profile. And so see you tomorrow with the puff pastry recipe. Until then, bye bye.